the top three fun things that you did.
Oh, fun thing?
The top three. Top three.
The first one.
For you lah, for you.
The first one should be.
The most funnest.
Fun thing is.
Most fun.
Fun thing is, I wake up because I cannot sleep, right?
Oh, oh.
So I was so early. I wake up one boy and I'm like, let's go eat breakfast at 5:30 something in the morning. And he was like, breakfast? Like now?
Yeah.
I said, yeah, let's go.
If you
go.
Wake me at 5:30, I'll slap you.
And me and him were drive.
I'll slap you at 5:30.
Me and him go around city. And nobody sell food yet.
We will have
to run the one like the banh mi shop, and the lady just take out the shop only and not even charcoal hot nothing. I say, I'm so hungry, right? Can you sell me banh mi or not? Like, I force her to sell me. Then I have to,
the auntie is like, can you just give me some?
Can you wait? And I like, no, I cannot wait.
Then she sell you the cold banh mi, is your what?
Yeah, she sent me the cold banh mi, but I'm still eat one. Cold banh mi in Vietnam is still amazing.
But you know it's cold because her charcoal not ready.
Yeah, her charcoal not ready, but I don't care what I eat. And then after I eat, I even buy 10 more. So I bring back for my whole team.
Hot or cold?
Cold lah, of course, no hot. Where got hot ones? So that's the first silly thing I did.
Banh mi is the...
The banh mi, the baguette. That,
oh, it's called banh mi.
Banh mi, yeah.
Banh mi.
And then the second silly thing I did is last
Force
minute...
Force your team to eat the cold banh mi.
Yeah.
That was the second silly.
Yeah. And the second thing I did is I went back and I didn't think I would go for do facial, right? And in the between of the time and I have like 2 hours and last minute, I just go in the place and I do facial and I do this. But on my
eyebrow embroidery,
yeah, I do all the thing last minute, and yeah, that's the other silly last minute thing I do. Then the third thing maybe is the night before I left, that I will have a very fun conversation with the owner of the homestay there.
Ah,
yeah, so we will have a deep conversation and now we'll be business partners just like that. So that's, you know, that's the fun of...
I wanted to show the eggplant, but that was highly inappropriate because it's a business fun. Sorry. I was just show the donut instead.
Oh, no. We really 100% the full night is talk about work, actually.
Yeah, I know. That's why it's inappropriate for the eggplant. But
yeah,
wow.
Yeah. So we were really like...
waste
but
my
because
time,
it's a male, female, and everything. He already have girlfriends. So of course, no. Nothing else besides work.
Yeah.
And I also like...
But it was a good connection, is it? Was
a
that
good
what
connection,
made it fun
for you? A good connection because this homestay is what I stayed 3 years ago.
Ah,
so I just
is it the one with the big bucks?
No, this one no big bucks. He's from Netherlands, so of course
no big bucks.
His place is
it's a Netherlands standard.
Yeah, so that's why if you go Vietnam, you go Ho Chi Minh, I will give you his address
please.
And use his place. Okay,
yes, please.
So because of his standard, that's why I want to do work with him because he do exactly the standard I do in Singapore, right? And I want to maintain that. If one day I want to do business in Vietnam, I don't want to
some yeah I know what I mean.
So because of that, and we will have did, yeah, so that's three fun thing that I was silly thing that I did, and I think it's
not like, exactly silly, but the most fun to me.
Fun lah, like last minute lah, but it's fun lah. But that's whole night we were drinking, smoking, eating, you know.
Smoking?
Whole night. Yeah,
smoking,
you know I'm not smoke, right?
You got smoke, are you?
I never smoke, but
you
I,
me.
But just because he smoked, so I was like.
You try ah.
You cannot don't smoke. When people smoke,
nonsense,
right?
No.
Yeah, so it's like...
No, I will just non-smoke.
Yeah, I know, but because two of us and it's awkward, so I'm like, okay, let's...
Only you awkward, I know awkward.
Yeah.
I'm very used to it already. Because I don't smoke, but a lot of my friends smoke.
I think sometimes if I have to go for certain meeting with like old man who smoke cigar, I have...
Cigar and whiskey.
Yeah, I did smoke like when I need to smoke cigar.
Oh.
Or like this kind of business,
yeah,
normally
I'll just drink whiskey.
But I smoke one just for show.
Just for show la.
Yeah, just for show.
To like, show that you can do whatever that they are.
Yeah,
doing.
So they don't feel like, oh, are you okay if I smoke? You know, sometimes the conversation is there. And,
yes,
and they're like,
really.
You want to?
Then
you,
then you will
one?
Break.
Yeah, yeah, like correct. It feel like, oh, okay, now just give me one. I continue, you know. So you just make them feel comfortable with the conversation. But yeah, I'm not smoking.
I see. Oh, that I will make people.
Not everybody can do business. Like,
I'm very.
From young,
I
already aware.
I will be very uncomfortable.
Yeah, from young, I already aware.
Actually, no. I don't know lah. Maybe when I get to that level, I don't think I will. I still don't think I will smoke. I will find some way to do it without smoking.
Yeah, of course.
I'll be like, oh, you go ahead, but I won't.
I did many times back, but that's when I decided I don't want to have that deal, then yes, different. But when it's some deal that I know, like, it's just because one smoke, I will have a deal, and I have to
I get what
try
you
to hold my gut. So that's why I don't judge people when they have to do business and they do this, because I understand, like, sometimes the smoke is important to you as much as somebody's smoke is important to them. So for you it's important that you don't smoke completely, right? For them it's the same. For them it's like, so if you don't smoke, you're not my friend, for example. So how you hold something important is the same thing for them. So by doing business, sometimes if I really don't like to deal with certain people, of course I will do what I want. But sometimes giving one thing is not lose anything. Then
yeah. No, it's not about losing. I think it depends.
Giving are not lose.
Yeah. So I think it also depends. But maybe number one, I'm definitely not doing business at that level. Number two, probably even if I do business, you have a different type of business.
Yes, correct.
And number three, I think my character a bit hard lah.
Yeah.
Oh, they wish that I will go and visit Vietnam someday.
Yeah, you have
to. Looking forward to see. Oh, if there's good music, I will surely be one of those dancing. And I will be one of those that will refuse to leave.
Very
now
good
continue,
music.
Continue, bring me some money.
But actually good that all music dance, they can dance, so they don't have to waste money to go clubbing second round, you know.
Clubbing? What is clubbing like in Vietnam? I'm very curious. Is it crazy?
So later I show you YouTube.
Is it dangerous?
No, dangerous.
Clubbing is not dangerous in Vietnam.
No. Of course, if you go with a local, that is different. But of course, you don't drink and go alone. Of course, of course we.
That means it's still a bit dangerous. Because Singapore, if you club alone, still doable.
No. Vietnam, I still recommend don't club
because
alone.
Singapore, I mean definitely.
Also,
if you are
foreigner,
alone,
right? They will know and they will pocket you and.
Really?
Sometimes
Singapore. You know what I mean by Singapore?
Yeah, no. Singapore, even you go clubbing, you book your wallet, your phone, everything there. Nobody touch one.
No,
when you go toilet, you come back, you see that one.
not all the time.
Even
okay.
You say lost, the police will come and stop the whole clubbing and on the light and on CCTV to check where is that for you.
Yeah,
so don't worry.
CCTVs everywhere. And
so
check.
It's like something that I tell you, like, it's so relaxed in Singapore because everything is so safe here. Go Vietnam, a different story. You see the bag that I bring to Vietnam, it's just a small big bag on me, like black color and ugly and horrible.
Why?
So my team will look at me and like, why you wear the bag so ugly one? Then I open for them. I said, it's ugly, but it's have 20K inside. So which one you want? You want a nice bag or you want a ugly bag with 20K inside?
No, but it's better to, I don't know, when I go overseas and travel, it's a habit to have bags that I can sling across.
Yes, and ugly and look disgusting. That
the older,
know
the color. Better.
Yeah, so that's
why for
I
the
go.
Pasar Malam is better.
Yeah, I don't, I will never.
How do you say Pasar Malam in? What is Pasar Malam? They don't know. Explain.
It's like kind of auntie stuff, old stuff.
No, like a night street thing. Pasar Malam is a night street. Have you been to Pasar Malam before?
Night street we have in Vietnam, but also
it,
same.
In Singapore,
not safe.
In Singapore, is it? Okay, have you been to Pasar Malam in Singapore?
Yeah, in Tao area, right? Where they sell food and stuff.
No! Pasar Malam are always in the neighborhood area.
Oh, really?
You never go before? It's those kind of pop-up shops. You never go before?
Pop-up shop is called nasi what?
Pasar Malam. You haven't go before?
Pop-up shop, I know. But there's sometimes they sell food, right? And
but it's a
in
whole
the place.
Group. It's
yeah,
whole
correct.
Group.
It's a whole group of sell food. And you just
and
walk
it's always very run down.
Yes, okay. Yeah, that's I know.
Okay.